And welcome back to Fiery Floor. We actually had a problem, so I'm beginning what I'm going to call Season 2 just because I figured out after the fact of our first video that I did not actually include to generate the strongholds we needed to get to the end to fight the Enderdragon. So the goals are the same, I just didn't get it right, so I revised it. I actually changed the... I'm gonna actually do that. Okay. I actually changed the superflat generation. We now have bigger villages close together because it's boring to be in just a barren desert, and that's what we had the first 10 minutes of our first attempt. So, we're going... So all the things are close together. Hopefully we'll be able to save some villagers this time, not have them turn into zombies. And if you are watching this one thinking it's the first one, you can just skip the first one that I did altogether. You don't have to go back and watch that one, because I have to re-explain everything here. Basically, the floor is magma. This is 1.12 because magma does not melt water, and to add a layer of complexity, you play this in 1.12 because in 1.13, magma does not get evaporated by magma, and we need that to make it just a little more complex. So now my goal is to actually save the magma. I'm at the water, not the magma. There's too much magma. To save the water before it all melts. So, we're going to have to do that. So we have to go through this village and hopefully find some loot that's a bucket. I need that. So, yeah. So, let's go find another smeltery. Okay. Probably should get this through. Bye. Oh, actually, we have extra water because of the villager well. Whatever. So see, as it's already, the crops are drying out because we're already losing the water. As you can hear, it's evaporating. So, yeah, it's already been completely evaporated. This trough just occurred. Because if you watch the video playback, you would see that it had some water. So actually, I don't have to worry as much because I made the world deeper. The well's not going to evaporate, so that's something good. So let's go into here. And I'm just going to mine it. Ooh. Okay, we got iron, so we got buckets now. We also got some pans. Ooh, got obsidian. I was hoping for the hard way to set up another portal, but I guess we get the easy way. So we'll put this here. Yep. Oh, messed that one up. Okay. So, I'm gonna kind of speed run what I did before because I've gotten a little more used to it. I've played a little bit more off camera and done. Yeah, a little more off camera and started to record the second episode, and then I noticed we had a problem, so decided to just redo the whole thing. Not try to scavenge the series because that had been hard to and been a lot of cheating and stuff to actually get to work. And a lot of boring scenes where I'm just walking across an endless desert of magma. Ouch. That would have been painful. So let's go find some here crops. And of course the villagers are so stupid they don't notice they're on magma, so they'll walk off into it. Sadly, they don't drop anything, so we can't do much about that. Wait, we have 2 diamonds. You know what? I'm gonna make an enchantment table. Because that's good. Good thing to have. And actually, okay, that's this first goal. We need to find a house that we're gonna set up our base. Because this place gets hectic at night. If you saw the first video, it gets nuts. The amount of spawns you get on roofs and stuff. Let's see if we can save any villagers. I'm gonna take lights that aren't needed in here because gonna need them around our base. Also should probably, now we probably want the doors to stay on. Oh wait, I forgot to change the difficulty to hard. Okay. Means we're gonna be running out of food quickly. So yeah. Let's see, is there any villagers still alive? I want these. They're rare, so they're very good for something. I actually am going to use them to decorate my base. I'm already worrying about the decoration, and it hasn't been 5 minutes in, and I'm probably going to die tonight. But, yeah, it's amazing how close I spawned to a village, but actually, it's if you looked around in the back, well, let's look around. Let's go outside. So if you look around, you'll notice that's a separate village. The villagers are so close now. I actually think that adds to the series, or the world, for the series, because it makes it so you're not walking across the barren deserts, as I've already said. Okay. I think actually, I'm going to actually build a base. I think I'm going to build a base right there. That's actually where I spawned, and if you remember, but I think that's a better idea, because then we don't get so many mob spawns. So we'll do that, and we probably should prepare for the night. It's already getting a little dark. I'm gonna use this to build a sword. Gotta keep my inventory sorted. Okay. Let's go, quickly. It's getting dark. The biggest problem we're gonna have is witches, because they have potions for this. For the lava madness. Okay. So I'm going to turn these into planks and make a temporary floor here to set up base. And the slabs, I believe, do not allow any monsters to spawn on them, so we're doing good there. It's becoming night. So we probably need some shelter. I'm going to go back. Oh. Ouch. Ouch. Okay, I need some logs. We probably should take the bookshelves. Whoa, whoa! That was bad. Walked right into the lava. Okay. Get rid of the glass. That'd actually be pretty good if we get an enchantment table early on, because it's kind of, we're almost restrained to mostly iron gear, which isn't too bad. Diamonds are really rare. I'm surprised I found diamonds, so I'm going to use them responsibly and make something that will last. Is it already... Wait a minute, let me track the sun. I'm confused. It's not day, is it? Is that the sun? Oh, is it still setting? Okay, I thought... Okay, my eyes are playing tricks on me. I'm in a darker room right now because it's the middle of winter. So I think it's getting darker. It's not actually that dark yet. It's just not even losing time. Whatever. This is actually recorded close to Christmas, so I'm gonna just say Merry Christmas. So this isn't really a Christmas-themed video because we're baking. Yeah, we're baking. Alright. Actually, it's kind of... We are... It's Christmassy. We're baking ourselves, though, not cookies. So, I guess it's kind of Christmassy. Okay, gonna get a shovel. And we're going to get the crafting table. And mine out all this dirt because we should start growing our own source of crops. I prefer bread, I think. I think the blocks are a little loud. I'm gonna turn them down just a tad. I'm just gonna turn the whole thing down just a tad. Not too much. Let's just find those separate thing. The blocks are rather loud in my headphones. I don't know if it's recording it loud. I think that's better. Okay, so we'll mine the dirt because we want to start our own crop production as soon as possible. This time we have an actual source of water that's not going to run out because the well generated that way. I might have to change the code for generate the superflat generating code again. But for now, we're just going to go with it. Now still, we should make our builds look kind of like things are desolate. Okay, now the sun is setting. Boink, boink. Okay. Probably should cook the salmon. And okay, I'll be right back. I need to do something. Okay, I fixed that. Let's go back. I'm gonna cut that part out, so you're gonna jump right to this. Okay, now we got some salmon, and it's night. See, they're already starting to come. They're already coming. A little sick. Okay, let's just start our farm then. We're gonna have to get some more seeds, because I'm gonna do a wheat farm, and I'm gonna have to get some water tomorrow. We should probably put some of our stuff in a chest so we don't lose it. And I'm really wishing I could just throw it all in with the help of mods, because I've been playing some mods lately, but no. We'll throw that in. And we'll throw that in. Okay, we're gonna need these, because I'm gonna do the rim in them. I'm gonna try to recreate what I was working on in the last one. Which, oh, I can't get to my inventory. Okay. So in the last one, I was making a farm that had that. And so basically, we start by doing slabs around this. Yeah, like that. So, once again, like I said in the last one, I'm playing this on 1.12 just to give it an extra layer of complexity. I actually like the new updates, and 1.14 is coming out soon. That's actually looking to be a pretty good update. Yeah. Let's see, 4. Yes. Yeah, they're revamping all the villagers and the villages and stuff in that update. It's looking pretty cool. I'm kind of hoping... Okay, we should probably figure out where the water's gonna go. I'm kind of hoping they give the villagers more than a random chance of an iron golem spawning. In my many years of playing Minecraft, I've actually not seen any iron golem spawn naturally. Ever. I've seen other YouTubers get them to spawn them naturally. I've never seen any of my friends do it. So I guess there's some pretty good pretty high specifications that have to occur, and the iron golem dies really quickly. It is not the best of mobs. It is like, in my opinion, I want that block. It's pretty idiotic how they don't respawn, so you get problems with your villages if you're trying to have them defend against the zombie raid things. You're basically going to have, with the iron golems, you're not going to have anything working well with that, because basically, it's like, come on. These iron golems, yes, they do some fancy throw, they throw some guys into the air very high, that's very cool, but at the same time, they're getting shot a lot. Yeah, and then with the introduction of the pillager raids, as they're called, on the villagers, that's gonna make it so they're gonna need even more defense. So I'm thinking, can't use that as fuel. You're gonna need to do something to make they're gonna have to revamp villager defenses, basically, my bottom line. So I'm kind of excited for them to announce it. If they don't, I'm gonna be really surprised. I'm expecting them to announce it sometime or put it in a snapshot. Which we're getting about like a snapshot every week. What is going on with my cursor? That is not normal behavior. I'm gonna have to fix that. Why is it doing that? Why is it splitting it in half? Okay, something's weird with that. Did it invert controls? Invert mouse is off touchscreen. Drop blah 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 blah. That is weird. Because every time I want to take one and it's not doing one. Maybe does it work on any of these other buttons? No. Something weird with that. I'll have to fix that or find out the problem. Okay, so now we want to get this going. Yeah, we got 7. I always overdo my estimations. And it's so dry out here. Gonna need a bucket. I'm gonna just make 2 buckets, even though we could just do one. And we don't need to go looking for the water to make an infinite heat source. I don't know why it's splitting it in half. That's never happened to me before. Let's go with an obsidian thing. So this will be our wheat thing. I'm going to make it multi-levered, leveled, water pouring through the top or the bottom. And then, yeah, so it's going to be water pouring through the very top, coming down through multiple levels into here, hydrating all the crops. I think that would look pretty cool. I've seen some pictures of something like that. So I'm going to work on that. So that will be one thing. We're going to make like a whole street, I think, here. So we probably want a material to make a street from, which, it's not letting me do that. Look, it lets me put it one. Oh, I forgot. Okay. Oh, I'm thinking Terraria right now. I've been playing too much Terraria, obviously. In Terraria, you do the right, the left click. No, it's the right click. And you'll get take out one, but in this you take out that half it. Okay, okay. There's nothing wrong with my things. I've just forgotten how to play Minecraft. Or non-modded Minecraft. I've been playing a lot of modded Minecraft in Terraria, so there's my excuse. You know what? Let's go down a level. And I don't have Vein Miner either now. Now I'm wanting Vein Miner. My finger is going towards the Vein Miner key. Yeah. Okay, we'll go down like this. Yeah, I think that looks pretty cool. Okay. And we'll go like that. Is it closer today? Getting my words mixed up. Okay. Yeah. Let's build this street. I think it looks pretty good. And then across the street we can have like a crafting station. So we'll do a 3-wide street. Copying village format. Let's go backwards. There. Don't have to get hurt. Should we make a little pathway off of it? Nah. Okay. We have one more torch. Let's put it on the edge of this. To discourage monster spawning, and one temporarily right there. The material, I'm already wasting it. The material, let's see. I guess we can show our richness. To show the richness of the base, we should do this. Yeah, like that. That looks pretty cool. We'll just gather some more. And that's pretty cool. Need some more cobblestone. So there we go. And then right there. Whoa, that scared me. I saw something running and then I just jumped into a hole. The good thing about this is even though they all spawn on roofs, when they come off the roofs, they mostly burn to death really quickly. Wow. And if I get too close to the houses, oh man, there's another one. They just start coming after me. Defend the fort. Well, that was a lot of XP. Or it sounded like a lot. I don't think it was a lot. Okay. Oh, what? 1, 2, 3. Still thinking. I'm still thinking Terraria. 1, 2, 3. Actually, I'm planning to do a Terraria series soon, so that will be interesting. But it seems like it's becoming day, and we can only stay for one day and night. That's the time limit on these episodes. And my timer is about to go off, I'm pretty sure of it. Yes, it is. Okay. So this video is done. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. This is pretty good. I'm getting better at this already. Because look how fast I did that. So we'll have to figure out how to kill the Enderdragon in the next video. Or the next one. Or the next one. Or the next one after that. Bye.